With so much going on in the world right now, what we don't need is a zombie attack. Unfortunately, it's not something we can really control, so it's always best to be prepared. But where to start? Luckily, here at The Hub, we're one step ahead of the game, and we've put together a list of 10 houses that will protect you against a horde of zombies. This video will help you find somewhere to stay in the event of a zombie attack, but how will you know what to do after that? Before we start, click the subscribe button and we promise you'll find all the other steps to survival in our other videos. Bjork's House. The singer uses her house in Selfoss as a sanctuary when she's not touring, so it makes sense that Bjork's house is pretty difficult to access. Based on the southern tip of this Nordic group of islands, the house was built in 1965 and contains any number of weird and wonderful items. The property is surrounded by nothing but grass, so admittedly it would be pretty easy for any approaching zombies to drop and hide. But they'd struggle to find provisions in the nearby area, which might hinder their attack. The entire town has only 6,500 residents, so we're not sure it would be at the top of the list for a zombie attack anyway. Surely they'd have more success in nearby mainland Iceland. But if they chose to take all this into consideration and attack anyway, the house has a perfect getaway route. It has a huge lake nearby. It's not the most convenient escape clause we've heard of, but we like to think we can swim faster than most zombies. And if we saw them approaching, we could definitely hold our breaths and hide underwater. On the plus side, unless these zombies are fans of popular culture, they might not have even heard of Selfoss at all. Bosco Verticale. When you translate the Italian back to English, Bosco Verticale becomes Vertical Forest. Well, as much as we can't give the creators much credit for originality, at least they summed up the property pretty accurately. Bosco Verticale spreads over two towers and reaches heights of 360 feet. At a first glance, you could be forgiven for not realizing that there are apartments scaled up from the ground because the 900 trees do a pretty good job of hiding them. If zombies tried to attack Bosco Verticale, you'd have a lot of time to prepare from the top. Sure, we imagine there's most likely a lift inside that will whiz you up to the top floor, but hopefully the zombies wouldn't be able to find that without a bit of searching around first. But once you've reached the top, while the zombies are still crawling around over 300 feet below, you'll be able to see for miles, giving you lots of time to plan an exit. Also, the handy design of the balconies means that if absolute worst came to worst, you could pretty easily jump down from floor to floor in order to escape without hassle. And when you're on your way down, you can appreciate the huge variety of plants surrounding the blocks. Summit Shock Incarceration Facility. It's otherwise known for being a correctional boot camp, and so this New York property probably isn't known for being at the top of anybody's to-visit list. However, it might actually be one of the safest places around if you're looking for somewhere to hide from zombies. It's also fairly spacious, so even if you got the biggest of families, there will be plenty of room for everyone. At full capacity, the facility holds around 45,000 people. So, at a push, your entire local town could simply relocate in case of a zombie attack. We're hoping it won't happen, but maybe you should spread the word in advance, just to be on the safe side. As the property was designed with the purpose of keeping people inside, it's very secure and difficult to exit or enter. So, even if you're trapped inside, maybe you should consider that it's equally as difficult for any approaching zombies to get inside. Surrounded by grass and built almost entirely out of thick concrete, it's not somewhere you'd be able to tackle in a hurry. If all else fails, the highly trained security guards might have a few zombie-fending tricks up their sleeves. Survival Condo, Kansas. Unlike some of the properties on this list, which just so happen to be coincidentally prepared for zombie attacks, the survival condos in Kansas were built for the exact purpose. Banking on those who are slightly neurotic, or perhaps just incredibly organized, the survival condos have 9 feet thick concrete walls that can withstand just about anything. However, this safety comes at a price, and it's certainly not cheap to save yourself against the apparently imminent zombie attack. A full floor unit costs $3 million and stretches for 1,820 square feet. Admittedly, it's not small, but we're not sure whether you really would be getting value for money here. If the price didn't put you off, and you were still ready to consider moving to this property block, we hate to be the bearer of bad news. Apparently, all 12 houses inside the block have already been sold. That makes someone a very rich man, considering we have no evidence to think that zombies will be approaching anytime soon. Although we may just be speaking for ourselves here, because a recent study conducted by National Geographic found that 41% of Americans think saving for a catastrophe is more useful than a pension scheme. The Silo Home. If you're looking for a cheaper alternative to our last option, then look no further than the Silo Home. It's based in New York, meaning you're close by to civilization if you decide to venture out of this protected bunker after the zombies have been gone. We'd like to know that we'll all be able to pop out to the shops if need be, even if we have our every need catered for us at the Silo Home. This is also the perfect home to trick zombies from entering, because it looks just like a standard house, It's only when you're inside the property when you become truly aware of the great underground elements. Also, unlike our last property, this one has had little market interest. When it was originally commissioned in 1958, it cost a staggering $18 million. In today's money, that's about $400 million. However, unsurprisingly, no one was ready to cough up that amount of cash, so the property has been steadily reduced over the years. It's now available for the small sum of $750,000, which is cheaper than a lot of properties you'll find in New York. We're also pretty certain that most other properties don't protect against zombie attacks, so you're technically getting a lot more for your dollar here. Dunbar Rock, Honduras. We wouldn't want to get caught up within a horde of zombies, but if it has to happen, we'd rather it happen at Dunbar Rock in Honduras than anywhere else. This place is possibly one of the most luxurious properties around, so we guess we can see the attraction for zombies to want to set up camp here. But the location of Dunbar Rock also makes it one of the most difficult for zombies, or us, to access. It's surrounded entirely by water, and the best way to get there is via helicopter. If that's not an option, then we'd recommend a boat, because it looks like a pretty long swim to the nearest island. In fact, it's almost 44 miles, so we'd hedge our bets on being attacked by zombies before we could complete the journey. This most definitely works to your advantage when hiding away from zombies, because unless we're behind the times, they don't know how to access helicopters. If you're looking for a holiday destination that's also secure enough to keep you away from unwanted visitors, then this could be a place for you. A week at the villa cost just under $2,000, making it a pretty worthy investment if your hometown did get attacked. But it gets booked up quickly, so you'll have to prepare in advance if this is your hideout of choice. Palace Bluegrass. This huge castle, often dubbed the Palace of Versailles, isn't actually in France, but instead is located in Kentucky. Spread over 232 acres of land, there's certainly plenty of space to run if zombies decided to invade. With 50 bedrooms, 16 guest suites, and 19 bathrooms, you'd even have a lot of places to hide. If you weren't stuck in such terrifying circumstances, it might even be great for a game of hide and seek. But more on that another time. Hopefully, with the security features surrounding this palace, the zombies wouldn't be able to get anywhere near. Surrounding the palace are thick concrete walls, so you'd have plenty of forewarning if our worst enemy decided to try and attack. There are also four turrets on each individual corner of the premises, so you could even take turns keeping an eye out if you suspected a zombie nearby. However, if you had to spend your last moments somewhere, and our Honduras hideout was fully booked, then this palace would be a pretty good choice. When you're not taking a nap in the endless bedrooms, you could be competing in a game on the rooftop basketball court, playing the grand piano or harp, or watching the giant satellite TV. A Thousand Islands. When we say A Thousand Islands, we're not just giving you an overview of the world and hoping you'll take your best shot on a random selection. A Thousand Islands is actually a group of islands between the United States and Canada, and is usually frequented by people with money to splash. Based on the St. Lawrence River, this archipelago is probably one of your safest bets in the event of a zombie attack. Because its inhabitants are pretty rich, the houses on each individual island are very well secured by numerous safety teams and special features. Put it this way, it's a great place to hide, but you might need to do a bit of sweet talking in order to be allowed inside in the first place. We imagine this is just to be cautious. However, years ago, the waters were frequented by pirates, not quite zombies, but also people you wouldn't want to stumble across without some preparation first. Now, thankfully, the waters are free from any unwanted guests, for the time being at least, but it's always good to be on the safe side, right? Regardless, we'd love to check out A Thousand Islands anyway, so we might even consider feigning a zombie attack just to check it out. 262 Tony's XRDS. Although it's based on 4 acres of land, this particular property is only supposed to house one family. So if you're trying to find somewhere to run with all of your extended cousins, then this place might not be the one for you. But before you throw it away entirely, you should consider that it's up for sale for under $130,000, which makes it far more realistic an investment than some of the others on our list. Another huge benefit to this property is how far away it's based from the main road. So if zombies stormed your local area, they might not even be aware of this house. You never know, they might be proficient at Google Maps, or have already planned out their route of attack. But we'll give them the benefit of a doubt for the time being. So if you've chosen this house, then try not to worry, because it was designed by a security mastermind. So it's about as high-tech as zombie-proof houses in 2017 can be. Combined with maple flooring, water purification systems, and stainless steel doors, what more could you really want from a property? Unfortunately, although this house is up for sale, we're told it can't actually be bought for the time being. So maybe we'll keep this one in mind for the future. 40 feet under. As the name would suggest, this home is primarily based underground, which, as long as you're not claustrophobic, could be a great place to try and relax in the midst of an attack. It's thought to be the cleanest missile silo in the world, so if you don't like to live in messy surroundings, then this place could almost be perfect. You wouldn't be shocked to hear that living underground means this property is difficult to access. For starters, if you're above ground, you can really only see the entrance, so we'd imagine many people have simply walked past and not even considered what could be lying deep underneath. Although saying this, the location of this silo is rather remote, so anyone who happened to stumble upon it in the first place would have to be taking a pretty extreme dog walk. The house does, however, have a long driveway, which we don't think is really typical for a property that's virtually underground. To complete the secure features, it also has a huge fence guarding it from outsiders. It's pretty much guaranteed not to leak, and apparently also keeps a consistently cool temperature. So this place could be pretty darn perfect as an emergency hangout location. Now that you know exactly where you're going to run if zombies do decide to pay us a visit, you can relax. Why not sit back and subscribe to the Hub so you can take your mind off of what will eventually happen? Now all you need to do is patiently wait for the apocalypse to begin. Fingers crossed it won't happen, but just in case, best of luck, and see you next time.